The Toromedal UP10 was introduced during 2019. It is the largest of Toromedal's cases and is marketed for up to 140-watt CPUs and 160-watt GPUs. It is a case almost without compromise in that it can be used with full-sized ATX motherboards, graphics cards, ATX power supplies, and still allow the use of several low-profile PCIe cards. To my knowledge, this is the only fanless heatsink case that allows multiple PCIe cards and a passively cooled graphics card. You can use a standard tower-style PC case with fanless components, but the GPU in such a case should be limited to 75 watts or less. Even Monster Labo's pending the Beast case is not really designed for multiple PCIe cards. There are a couple of compromises, however, which I will expand on towards the end of this video. The man behind Toromedal, Michael, will provide a custom CPU cooling system for use with this case if you are interested. This is recommended for higher power CPUs, since the default CPU cooling system is designed for compatibility with a wide range of motherboards, and is not the most thermally effective design as a result. A couple things set Toromedal apart from its competitors in a good way. Their cases include the use of 8mm heat pipes instead of the 6mm heat pipes that you will generally see. 8mm heat pipes can transfer 25-45% more heat than 6mm heat pipes. Also, many of Toromedal's cases use a third heatsink in the front of the case that shares heat pipes from the heatsinks on each side of the case. This adds heatsink volume and surface area, and allows the heatsinks to share the heat dissipation workload more evenly. Now here's the downside. These designs come at a cost. The UP10 is available for $770 directly from Toromedal, and this is effectively for a pre-order. Shipping can take between 7 and 60 days, as the cases are mostly pre-assembled by hand, and will depend on how busy Michael is at the time of order. So, this case is definitely not for everyone, but for those who can make use of its advantages, it might be the best option. The UP10 is made of aluminum and includes 28mm nickel-plated copper heat pipes. Yes, 20 of them. It weighs over 25 pounds when empty. The width is 17.3 inches, the depth is 13.2 inches, and the height is 6.1 inches. The system featured in this video will include the Intel i7-10700 CPU, ASUS Phoenix GTX 1660 Super OC graphics card, ASUS ProArt Z490 Creator Motherboard, 32GB of TeamGroup Vulkan Z DDR4 3200MHz memory, a 250GB Samsung 970 EVO Plus NVMe SSD, two 2TB Crucial MX500 2.5-inch SSDs, an audiophile JCAT USB card XE, an ASUS PCIe AC55BT Wi-Fi and Bluetooth card, and a Silverstone NJ450 SXL SFX fanless power supply. The system is being used by a customer for real-time DSD upsampling with convolution filtering. If you'd like to get right to the test results and conclusion, you can skip the next 25 minutes.
The book.
You might have noticed that the PCIe riser for the graphics card was not long enough to reach the motherboard's top x16 PCIe slot. This is one of two downsides that I noticed. Most consumer motherboards only include 16 PCIe lanes in the first or second slot, so bandwidth will be limited to 8 PCIe lanes with most motherboards. This is not a problem with lower-end graphics cards, but if you want to maximize the potential of this case, you want to go with a mid-range graphics card, which would be limited by using just 8 lanes. To test the performance of the system, I ran Passmark's performance test. Overall, the system received 4.5 stars out of 5. The CPU received 4 stars, 2D graphics received 4.5 stars, 3D graphics received 3.5 stars, memory received 5 stars, and the drive received 4.5 stars. This system performed in the top 6% of all results, pretty impressive for a 100% passively cooled PC. This is without even maximizing the case's full potential. I did some extensive thermal testing of the system to try to find out what the case's limits are, with the help of Prime95, Firmark, and Hardware Info. I tested the CPU at various power limits, initially at 20 watt intervals, but I came back the next day to test the CPU at 15 watt intervals as well, after I saw the initial results. When I got to the 100 watt power limit, the CPU began to thermally throttle after about 5 minutes. The next day, during the 90 watt power limit test, the CPU didn't even make it to 5 minutes. The highest power limit that the CPU did not throttle at was 80 watts. This is not bad, but for a case that is not far from $1,000 and is marketed for up to 140 watts, this was somewhat disappointing. I contacted Michael about this and confirmed my suspicion. The CPU cooling system that comes with the case is designed for compatibility over performance. The length of the heat pipes, due to the 180 degree curve back to the heatsink, significantly limits their performance. They are simply too long. This is where a custom CPU cooling system comes in. If you contact Tor Metal, they are able to provide a better CPU cooling system depending on the motherboard that you plan to use. I don't doubt that 140 watts is possible with the right heat pipes, but it certainly is not possible with the default heat pipes. I would stick to about 80 watts without a custom solution. Somewhere between 80 watts and 90 watts for me, these long heat pipes simply failed to keep up. Moving on to Firmark and the GPU, things looked a lot better. The default heat pipes have very little length between the GPU and the heatsink, and the results are much different as a result. The GTX 1660 Super only got up to 145 watts, but even then, the maximum GPU temperatures were about 50 degrees above ambient. When I plot the temperature above ambient versus the power use, it looks like the case can easily handle over 160 watts from the GPU. I haven't had a chance to test it yet, but it looks like the case might be able to handle a 200 watt RTX 3060 Ti quite well. In conclusion, the UP10 is a unique fanless heatsink case that offers compatibility with a wide range of component configurations. It's massive for an integrated heatsink case, but its potential performance is fantastic for a passive solution. I say potential performance because on the CPU side it depends largely on the heat pipe system offered with the case. If you are looking for a high-end fanless PC case that can cool mid-range graphics cards and has space for multiple low-profile PCIe cards, the UP10 is likely the best option available. Visit fullysilentpcs.com if you are interested in supporting this work and purchasing your own custom-built fanless PC. Thanks for watching. Like this video, share it, and subscribe for more fanless PC content.